part of the core duties of the Electoral Commissioner. Indeed, Article 45 plus paragraph F of the Constitution, simply, the Electoral Commissioner shall perform such functions as may be prescribed by law. The Procurement Act is one of such laws of Ghana, and therefore, he or she is necessarily required to uphold those provisions. And therefore, when he or she falls foul of the provisions of the Act, clearly, it's a very serious matter which should ground an application for his or her removal from office, as the case may be. And it is very important to note that the Procurement Act itself stipulates that a breach of any of the provisions of the Act constitutes an offence. The punishment for such a breach is imprisonment of up to 5 years in prison. So how can one reasonably contend that an act which is done, which can land a person in jail, is not good enough to ground a removal from office of that person? I think that the Electoral Commission is a very important institution of state, and the functions imposed on it by the Constitution are also very onerous and has far-reaching implications for all of us as citizens. And therefore, the Electoral Commissioner, who is the head, or the chairperson of the Electoral Commission, who is the head of that entity, ought to really act in accord with the laws of Ghana. And as the Supreme Court has observed, the performance of procurement duties really constitutes much of the core functions of the Electoral Commission. So even going by the plaintiff's own argument, clearly there was no cause for action at all. And I think the court was very much justified in dismissing the suit today.
Thank you.